All right, so the big international story that we are tracking is what's unfolding in Greece. The Greek tragedy is pretty much making all markets, global or Indian markets, really cry. What's happening? How does it really impact our markets? Let's go across to Shweta.
Thanks very much for that, Kulsum. Yes, there have been fast-paced developments in Greece over the weekend, and that has clearly sent shivers across the globe, including in the Indian market. So let's take a look at what has really happened. What is the big picture with regard to Greece, and why should India be worried if there's a financial crisis in Greece? Well, we're calling it clearly the Greek tragedy, and what has happened is that Greece has ordered for its banks and stock markets to be shut down, and that's essentially to avoid any mass withdrawals. Even as they're seeing a virtual collapse now of their financial system. Already they've seen withdrawals of over $4 billion. But why is that happening? Well, Greece, that has been facing financial troubles for a long time, is now likely to miss the deadline of making payments to the International Monetary Fund, or the IMF, by the 30th of June, which is tomorrow. So tomorrow is the deadline for Greece to go ahead and make its payments. But will it default? That remains a larger question. Well, if it does default and if it fails to make payments, it is likely to be pushed out of the Eurozone. And that is something that will have a ripple impact across the global financial system. And as we said, already $4 billion has been withdrawn in the last 2 weeks, and withdrawals continuing, even though now the government has put strict caps, capital controls are in place to ensure that people are not withdrawing. But let's take a look at the key developments and what has led us to this crisis that is clearly impacting everyone before we take a look at why India should be worried, if at all. So look at the key developments. Well, the deadline to pay IMF is, of course, Tuesday, which is 30th of June. So far, Greece has rejected the offer of budget cuts and reforms. And this was an offer which was given by the IMF, the European Commission, and the European Central Bank. So an offer of a proposal which was given to Greece is something that has been rejected by them, and which is why overnight they have been taken by surprise by the fact that the Greek Prime Minister called the offer nothing but a humiliation of the entire Greek people, and in fact has now gone ahead and asked for a referendum to take place on the 5th of July. And of course, seeking an extension of the bailout. So what Greece is essentially saying, give us an extension, and that we will hold a referendum on the 5th of July on this offer that has been made by the three institutions. And only then a decision will be taken whether or not to accept that offer for bailout. But the EU member states so far have refused to extend the bailout, which means 30th June, which is Tuesday, remains the deadline for Greece to make its payments. The big question, will it default? And what happens if it defaults? There are worries, of course, that a default is likely. Greece will be pushed out of the Eurozone, and which is why we're seeing markets across the globe tanking. Why should markets across the globe be worried about Greece defaulting on its payments? Well, remember, a lot of European banks have a lot of exposure to Greek debt, and that's the reason why we're seeing these banks clearly pulling out funds, and the Indian markets have also reacted sharply to that news. Let's pull up Sensex and Nifty and see how the markets have done. Well, the Sensex now down about 200 odd points, so we've seen that good recovery coming in the last half an hour or so. But when markets opened in the morning, we saw a sharp dip. Sensex was down over 600 points in trade today, but now it has definitely come off the day's lows that we'd seen, trading about just about 200 points in the red. So sort of more developments there taking place, some hope they're building up that perhaps there could be a solution at the nth hour that could be found to the Greece crisis. Once again, take a look at the Nifty, that is now down about 75 odd points, a little less than 1%, but the Nifty was also deep in the red in the morning. It has now come off the day's lows and is now in fact gaining strength as we speak. So even as these developments keep on continuing, we're keeping a close eye on what could be the final solution with regard to Greece. But take a look at the top losers. Tech Mahindra topping the charts. It's in fact tanked over 7% today. And this is primarily on account of worries with regard to Tech Mahindra's earnings for the first quarter. Tech Mahindra has issued a warning that its first quarter earnings may not be up to the mark, and it may actually see a decline. And that's what has sent the stock down over 7%. Hindalco, HCL Tech, SBI among the other top losers on the Nifty. So what's really pulling down markets today? Well, weak sentiment with regard to Greece. Globally, that's a fear that has built up. Wipro and other stocks also down in the red today. And overall, also worries with regard to corporate earnings continuing to be weak, weaker than what was expected. That's clearly pulling down the tech stocks. So IT, banking, auto, all of those have been impacted overall by the sentiment. But we're keeping a close watch on what will finally happen with regard to the financial developments in Greece. That's all from me. It's back to Kulsum.